Closing in on the signal.
That girl was wound up tighter than a twisted spring.
Now she's in the wilds, all alone. Forge knows all the things that could kill her out there.
Someone ran off?
Never got her name. Kept quiet. Couldn't tell if she was shy or scared. All I know is she didn't want anyone near her things.
That's for sure. I was just curious, is all. She didn't have to slug me.
Your glass jaw ain't the problem, Lugnut. The girl is. All alone in the bush? And this is Tanakh territory.
Which way did she go?
West, up the slope. Look for her if you can.
I will.
Careful now. The girl's maladjusted.
Eyes up here, sister! Look at you!
Have I got news for you, Red?
Wind is bracing, I guess. Are you lost?
Spark to steel. Aren't you a jewel in a junk heap?
Excuse me?
Hold the hammer? I know you. You're that Nora. Ha ha! The savior! My savior! Right in the nick of time. The name's Porguff Delvesman, chief delver and leader of Porguff's expeditioners and purveyors of fine delvewares.
What am I saving you from, exactly?
Death and despair, my steel flame friend. See, this grand expedition here has had a minor setback. Not far from here, there's a secret tunnel. A passage of the old ones, lost and then found. Me and half the crew came through first. The other half was supposed to follow right after. But days later, only one man turned up, shivering like a frog in chill water. Only thing we got out of him was that death and darkness chased them as the tunnel collapsed. Died with his eyes wide, he did.
I've been to the tunnel's eastern side. The way was blocked by rubble. There was also a body, one of your delvers, I guess, but no sign of the rest of the crew.
Keep your voice down, will you? The rest of the crew's already spooked. They're refusing to press on with the Delve until they're assured a way out of here.
You lost half your crew and you're worried about the Delve.
We gotta make their sacrifice worth something, right? And besides, now that you're here, maybe our sand-stranded days are over. Help me get that tunnel reopened, and I'll cut you in on the Delver's fee. What do you say?
So this camp, it's your base of operations?
What operations? The plan was to move further south once the rest of the expedition joined us. The Delve is right out beyond those dunes. But now the crew refuses to budge until this tunnel mess gets sorted out. They've even given this place a name. Camp Nowhere. I think they're mocking me.
Yeah, I think they are. Was there a Karja traveling with your expedition? A man by the name of Amadis?
We always pick up a few travelers on the road. Akaja here, Banuk there. Never learn their names, though. They don't stick around long. But I have a scout who might know. Likes the whole getting to know people thing. He's out surveying the area, trying to find some other route out of here. Should be back later, if he doesn't get himself killed.
Right. I'll see what I can do about the tunnel.
My savior.
For the crew trapped here with you, not your Delve.
One and the same.
That it, over there?
That it is. Oh, and while you're at it, would you mind keeping an eye out for my lockbox? The second crew was supposed to bring the rest of the supplies and belongings. I'd hate to lose it to the wilds. It was hand-carved by my dear old Ma.
I'll bring it back, if I find it.
I'd appreciate it. Good luck, Steel Flame.
Got something you'll want to hear, Red.
Oh, hi!
You might want to avoid going too deep into the desert, especially the southwest. One of our scouts ran into some nasty Tanakh down there, the kind that contain machines. He barely made it back alive.
Thanks for letting me know. Rebels are as friendly as ever. I wonder what they're doing this far out in the desert.
of pork up there.
Yeah, it's you! Took you long enough!
That's what my focus picked up. Tallneck. Someone said I'd find one here. This looks like Osirin gear. It must be the crew I heard about while I'm tracking a Tallneck. Where are they up to? Osirin used some kind of harpoon to take this machine down. It must have attacked the camp. Maybe my focus can help me figure out why. These Osirin were killed by machines. So the one they took down wasn't alone. These are Tallneck antennas. The Osirin must have stripped them somehow. Trying to take down that Tallneck. So the Osirin wanted to weigh down that Tallneck and strip it for parts. The machines must have caught them in the act. I wish there was a way to climb up and inspect the damage. Unless I take down the Tallneck myself and try to repair it on the ground. It'd be pretty, but at least it'll get fixed.
Hello to you too!
Looks like the machine takes this one too. I'll have to hook an anchor to the weak spots in its armor to weigh it down. I gotta hook the anchor to the helmet's weak spots. Another ballista, and it's got one of the anchors I need. One more should weigh it down enough. I need to hurry. I've already attached an anchor here. I need to get more in the area. I bet a ballista can help me fight these machines. Use that ballista. I should look for others in the area. Thank you. weapon still has an anchor. Let's use it. I can grab this for my stash later. Those legs look too difficult to climb. I'll have to find another way. Looks like it's on a mission. shelter. Chance to rest and check my gear. Someone in their crew ran off in this direction. I should keep my eyes open.
Get away from my rig! It's on to me.
She's gonna need some help. think she's gonna need some backup. Make sure she's okay.
Supply drop.
All right. Why, the spike is still intact. Rig's still playing. You okay there? You took out those machines. I'm grateful, but you should go now. There's nothing to see here.
So this rig of yours, it's receiving sound through that wire from the thing up on the cliff, what you call a spike. But the message is only a fragment, and you're trying to pick up the whole thing?
How did you figure all that out?
I've learned a few things in my travels. If you want, we could talk about it. Maybe I can help.
You do seem downright knowledgeable. So go ahead. Shoot.
Your rig's impressive. How does it work?
Well, like you said, the spike up there seems to capture the sound. It travels by wire down to my contraption. I put some coils in there and a light sheet of metal that vibrates, making the sound louder. I'm not exactly sure why it works, but it just does.
And you set it up out here all alone?
I'm not the trusting type. Pretty much everything I do is all alone.
How did you first hear the message?
I used to be a smith up in the claim. Wasn't an easy life. A lot of hard work without much to show for it. Then one day, I heard a whisper coming from a steel rod. Faint. Like the last fingers of steam coming off. When I moved the rod around, the whispers got louder. I did some tinkering. Further west I came, the stronger it got. When I hooked up my rig, the words were clearer than ever.
What do you think the message is?
I don't know. There's something sad about it. Feels like it's from one lost soul to another. I'd sure like to know what it means.
Let me have a look at that spike. I might be able to pick up more of that message.
How?
Let's just say I have a rig of my own.
I didn't know Nora were tinkers.
They're not, but I am, in a way. Be right back.
Well, okay then. I guess. Just follow the wire to the spike at the top. And then, please, just don't break anything.
Stuff for the stash.
Thank you.
Better get climbing. Give her credit, lugging all that wire up a cliff wall. There's a spike. Might get better reception if I'm next to it. Interesting. Can't seem to get a fix on where the signal's coming from, though. Well, better let the Tinker know I got a bit more of the message. This ought to be a good shortcut. Your rig is picking up an old-world message. A recording of some kind.
Thought as much. Did you hear more of it?
A bit. It was recorded during a war. A bad one.
Maybe that's why it sounds so darn sad. There's something about it that makes me think of my late brother. May his ashes stay warm in the forge. Not sure why, exactly.
I still can't get a fix on the source.
Well, the words grew stronger when I got out here.
What if you moved the rig now? Try to see if you can get a stronger signal elsewhere.
Even if I could dodge the Tenakt and the machines, I can't lose that spike. Nothing else pulls down the words better.
Okay. If it's an old world message, then let's try old world methods. They used to pinpoint signals by listening for them at three different spots. The taller, the better. And then they combined the information and used it to find the source.
And you can do that?
I think so. But your spike is only one spot. I need two more, both up high.
Well, there's a big bright tower in the Tenakth territory north of here.
Yeah, that should work. I have another spot in mind, near a place I'm, camping.
Wait. I don't know your name. Or why you do all of this for someone you just met.
Aloy. And because I want to know what's out there. Same as you.
Silga. And when you find it, Aloy, I'd be eager to hear what it is.
Thank you.
Gotta climb up to look for Silga's signal. Signal. Hera is sick with his heat. Higher. Almost there. Okay, let's see if I can pick up Silga's signal. I got more of the message, but not enough to find the source yet. Climbing the mountain where my base is should finish the job. Ain't this easy?
I see you, champion. Sit, please.
If you walk by, you'll miss out on a good trade.
You look geared up.
The southern face is my best bet for a climb if I want to get more of Silka's message. Just gotta look for a path. Huh.
I needed that. About to pick up Silga's signal. This is quite a climb. I have to get higher to try and pinpoint Silga's signal.
Looks like I have company. I need to climb higher. Okay, now to pick up the signal. Where's the best spot? I should try to find a good spot to pick up Sega's message. There. Found the signal's origin. It's not too far from here. I just need to get to it. Then I'll get a nice view if I glide down from here.